are you?
I feel no better. I long for the mist of death, the shadow country. But the hot wolf blood keeps me alive. The monster in me is tenacious and terrible. I am becoming a beast.
No,
it's all so dark.
Fortune finally smiled.
I was killed, damn your eyes! Rhiannon! That accursed.
Of course, I'm sure.
Are you actually sick?
You must do more than.
Hurry!
Kill Rhiannon!
Thank you.
Who disturbs the demon?
We must.
You spoke with the demon, Rade. That was my...
He dislikes being...
I will wait for you on this side or the other.
careful.
What? Let me rest. Just a bit. And I'll be ready to fight.
Make it quick. Get to work.
Eh? Hmm? Then speak we shall. For many people, their lives are devoid of real choice, plotted out by the stars, or simply beneath the notice of the gods. But you, you worry me. Old Sharrak senses great powers arising, focused on you. The art of weaving words, simple enough for you to understand, is one I have labored many years to master. The gods will, and fate itself, decide what I may say. You will never realize the difficulties in speaking through mortal tongues when you see with divine vision. I've not been idle. Reading the stars is how I interpret the turning of destiny, and I see the attentions of both gods and men turn towards you. You are the storm's eye, and soon all around you will erupt into chaos. But as for now, now you have an old score to settle, I think. An old enemy awaits you in Cimmeria. You know her from your days on Totarj, where she served Tohomon then as she serves him still. Mitrel, minion of Tohomon, will die before she lets you take what she protects. And you know something else? She hates you. She hates you with such venom, I see her rage written in the stars. Do not be so slack-jawed at the whims of chance. This was fate. You were destined to face her and take vengeance. I've been to that gray, desolate land many times. The rains are cold, the winds colder, and the women colder still. My time there is always most unpleasant. High in the Eglofian Mountains, your old enemy. If it is the will of the gods that you return, I will help restore more of your memory if I am able. When you reach the village close to the mountains, speak with an elder called Niall. He will guide you further. May the benevolent aspects of our pantheon watch over you in your northern travels. I still dream night after night of Tohomon whispering to the idol. The Phoenix Medallion appears within my visions also, burning with light, where the idol is utter blackness. My fears grow deeper and darker, and I wonder if this amulet is worth more than a mere means of banishing your mark of Acheron. But we will speak of such things later, perhaps. Run along then, plaything of the gods.
Yes? Pictish savages, berserkers of Vanaheim, and subhuman flesh-eaters infest the wilds all around us. My life is an endless trial, day by day, just to survive. I know what you've come seeking. Leave our village by heading north, and be ready to fight your way through Crom only knows how many flesh-eaters that dwell in the mountainside. There's a path leading up the mountain, leading to a cave. Whatever foulness you've come looking for is... I know what I know from seeing it myself. Yes, I still try to hunt for my village, even at my age. Even with the wind turning my bones to ice and my muscles weak from the climb. I was the last one to venture up there some weeks ago. Crom, you're not deterred even for a moment. Well, off with you then. You won't be buried after they kill you up there in the wilderness. But I've always thought it nobler to be eaten by wolves than worms once you're dead.
Gods go with you. turn to heal at last, you treacherous worm. You will not leave this chamber alive, my wretched apprentice. Now come, traitor. I'll flay your filthy soul from your body for what you've done to me.
Yeah. Thank you.
So it seems. And I suppose I should take the role of the proud patron, should I? Is that what would please you? All Charak clapping and smiling and telling all of his students' great feats of skill and courage. It pains me to hear you say such words. Yet it surprises me not one bit. Very well, spiteful one. We will discuss what you came to discuss. With another piece of the Phoenix Medallion, the process should be even easier than ever before. Are you ready? Hand me the Phoenix of the North, and I'll begin. I sense something. Almost a presence, or a voice barely heard. It's almost as if someone or something calls out from the medallion you wear. But no, it fades. How rare to sense such a presence. Forgive me, are you ready? Focus once more, and we shall part the curtain of your closed mind. That's the point of all this wizardry. You're supposed to feel stronger. Tell me, how do you focus that strength? Do you recall? Then we have succeeded. Though your memory may be in shadow still, more of your former power has broken through the curse of the mark and returned to you. When it happened, I felt the same presence as I had a moment ago. Curious. For a moment, no longer than a heartbeat, I felt as though there was something within the Phoenix Medallion, something calling to you. Perhaps it grows stronger as the pieces fall into place. I know not. What I do know is that a certain priest of Ibis wishes to bend your ear. He has a message from the Aquilonian king. We share a sentiment, you and I. Truly, the man could talk the ears off a dead jackal. Find him in Old Tarantia awaiting you. The Aquilonian king has taken note of your deeds, for it's Conan's order that sent Colontis out to seek you. Look for a building with a blue door by the auction house. Run along then, plaything of the gods.
Kill!